Brothers and sisters, let us think today how many favor of Allah we carry with us, the gifts of Allah, the bounties of Allah, day and night is falling upon us. We're drowned almost in the different, various, numerous types of favors of Allah. Yet we complain. We have this problem, that problem. Yes, there is test in the life. We are not in paradise, we're not in Jannah. Yes, today I got headache. Tomorrow, somebody was very rude to me. Other day I fall ill. So this kind of things, part of the life. But when something small problem happened to us, bit of pain, we are very concerned about this. It becomes very dominant in our thought. And we forget how much favor is with Allah. That is something we need to always appreciate Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that how much He has given us. As Allah said in the Quran, look at your own self, your body, your organ. You are a fit person. You're physically able. Some people are tested by disability. You're not. Your children are good, physically fit. Others' children are disabled. They are not. At least remember all these. Okay, so and be grateful to Allah. However, if you are tested, have sabr. Iman has two halves. One half of the faith is shukr, gratefulness, and other half is sabr, patience, perseverance. So these are the two. So Allah is giving us so much gift, even though you have didn't get a job yet, you have some kind of physical illness, but you look at yourself, you carry so much gifts and favors of Allah with you. He said, وَهُوَ الَّذِي أَنْشَأَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ قَلِيلًا مَّا تَشْكُرُونَ. And it is He who produced for you hearing and vision and hearts, which is include intellects. Little are you grateful, as Allah says. Everybody get favor of Allah, either you're Muslim or non-Muslim, whatever. Even somebody is atheist, doesn't believe in Allah, he gets the favor of Allah so much. وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْسُوهَا. If you go to count favors of Allah upon you, you'll be never ever able to count it. Countless favor of Allah. However, he's saying to the believers, the biggest favor of Allah to you, O believers, is a belief in Allah. The Iman, the faith. Islam, the chosen religion of Allah. He's reminding us about this. قُلْ بِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُوا هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا يَجْمَعُونَ. Say, in the bounty of Allah and His mercy, in that let them rejoice. It is better than what they accumulate. If you see other people are having so much wealth, power, all this comfort of the life, and you got in your custody, in your position, the Iman, the faith, you need to rejoice more than these other guys. This is the biggest favor of Allah. He has chosen you to believe in Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, referring to our Prophet, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ شَاهِدًا وَمُبَشِّرًا وَنَذِيرًا وَدَاعِيًا إِلَى اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِهِ وَسِرَاجًا مُنِيرًا وَبَشِّرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ بِأَنَّ لَهُم مِّنَ اللَّهِ فَضْلًا كَبِيرًا. O Prophet, indeed we have sent you as a witness and a bringer of good tidings and a warner and one who invites to Allah by His permission and an illuminating lamp, and give good tidings to the believers that they will have from Allah great bounty. And that is referring to Jannah, to paradise. Allah said also, we need to appreciate Allah's favor of giving us Iman. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَصَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا هُوَ الَّذِي يُصَلِّي عَلَيْكُمْ وَمَلَائِكَتُهُ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا تَحِيَّتُهُمْ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ سَلَامٌ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَرِيمًا. O you who believe, remember Allah with much remembrance and exalt Him morning and afternoon. It is He who confers blessing upon you and His angels that He may bring you out from darkness into the light. And ever is he to the believers merciful. They are greeting the day they meet him will be peace, salam, and he has prepared for them a noble reward in Jannah. So that is the biggest favor of Allah to the believer, that he's shown them the right path to go to the paradise. However, if you don't be grateful to Allah, it is not a big loss for him. Why he is so keen to get your remembrance, your gratefulness, it is not that he is very looking for that for his own benefit, his own interest. No, it is for your own interest. That's why he said, "In takfuru fa inna Allaha ghaniyun ankum wa la yarda li ibadihi al-kufr wa in tashkuru yardahu lakum." If you disbelieve, indeed Allah is free from your need of you, and he does not approve for his servants' disbelief, because it is harmful for you. It is your own disaster. And if you are grateful, he approves it for you. Of course he is happy. He is because you are doing something which you are created for, and you deserve its reward. Now, shukrullah wajibun fi jamil ahwal. We need to thank Allah in all occasions. In the youthfulness, when you get the old age, if you are well, even if you are unwell, if you are rich or you are poor, if you are so busy or if you have spare time, if you are so happy or if you are going through a difficult time, if you are sleeping or even if you are awake, if you are traveling or in your local area, in all time, every day, every night, every morning, every evening, we need to remember Allah and to perform our gratefulness to him. How we can do it? How we'll be grateful to Allah? By three ways. One is to realize, to appreciate Allah's ni'mah in ourselves. Yes, Allah has done so much favor to me. Second thing, even to talk about this. Alhamdulillah, Allah has given me this. Alhamdulillah. How are you? I'm very good, mashallah. Say confidently, say with real feeling that you really enjoy the ni'mah of Allah. Don't say, well, I'm very tired. Just, this is an expression where you deny all Allah's ni'mah to you. I'm very ill, so you deny all the ni'mah. Yes, you can say, after that, yes, I have some headache, I have this problem, that problem, but don't remember of mentioning the ni'mah of Allah you enjoy. Third, which is most important as well, not to use this ni'mah, this gift, this favor of Allah to commit any sin. Beautiful eye, Allah has given to you the eyesight to look all this creation. Do you use it now to commit sin? Allah has given us sustenance, given us wealth, money. Do you utilize this money, wealth, to commit sin? Allah has given us hand to hold many things. Do we utilize it to hit somebody, to commit some kind of sin? All this we need to think. Utilizing every ni'mah for good purpose, not for any wrong reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself like gratefulness. He said himself, he is shakur, he is shakir. He is the one who is very grateful himself. He would like us to be grateful as well. He said, فَذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ وَشْكُرُوا لِي وَلَا تَكْفُرُونَ. So remember me, I will remember you, and be grateful to me, and do not deny me. We can't deny himself. مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ شَاكِرًا عَلِيمًا. What would Allah do with you, punishment, if you are grateful and believe, and ever is Allah appreciative and knowing? He also said, وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ, and few of my servants are grateful, because shaitan doesn't like, will be grateful to Allah. He'll be coming from right, left, and front, behind, to tell us that we deny Allah's favor, we don't acknowledge, we don't appreciate. Always maybe what problem we have, highlight that, that's all we are occupied. He said, إِنَّ هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. Indeed, we guided him, the man, the insan, to the way, be he be grateful, be he grateful, or be he ungrateful. And he's mentioning the example of Sulaiman alayhi salam, the Prophet. Allah made him king as well. After getting receiving Allah's ni'mah, he said, "Hada min fadli Rabbi liyabluwani aashkur am akfur. Waman shakara fa innama yashkuru li nafsih. Waman kafara fa inna Rabbi ghaniyun kareem." He said, "This is from the favor of my Lord to test me whether I will be grateful or ungrateful. And whoever is grateful, his gratefulness is only for the benefit of himself." And also Allah increases the ni'mah. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And when you and your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you in favor. But if you deny, indeed my punishment is severe. How we can be grateful to Allah? By praising him, by beautiful dua and azkar, sabah and masa, evening and morning. One of the evening dua, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if anybody said in the morning, man qala hina yasbih Allahumma ma asbaha bi min ni'matin faminka wahdaka la sharika lak, or another riwayah, ma asbaha bi min ni'matin aw ahadin min khalqika faminka wahdaka la sharika lak falaka alhamdu wa laka ash-shukr faqad adda shukra yawmihi وَمَنْ قَالَ ذَٰلِكَ حِينَ يُمْسِي فَقَدْ عَدَّى شُكْرَ لَيْلَتِهِ. Whoever says in the morning, "O Allah, whatever blessing has been received by me or any one of your creation is from you alone. You have no partner. All praise is for you. And all gratefulness for you." If he says this dua in the morning, he have performed grateful gratitude of the whole day. If he says in the evening, he has performed his gratefulness to Allah for whole night. Then we can see another dua, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling Sahabi Mu'adh, "Ya Mu'adh, inni uhibbuka. La tad'u an taqula dubra kull salatin, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa ala shukrika wa ala husni ibadatik." O Mu'adh, I love you. And you should not miss after every prayer by saying of this dua, "Wa Allah, help me for remembering you and to be grateful to you and to do a good ibadah of you, to worship you in a better way." Don't miss this dua after any prayer you perform. In another beautiful zikr of doing Allah's shukr is Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, قد سمع صلى الله عليه وسلم رجلا يقول الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه قال لقد ابتدرها بضع وثلاثون ملكا أيهم يحملها. So one day a man said a dua, a dhikr, the meaning of that is all praises for Allah, abundant, good and blessed praise. He said that, and Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I have seen more than 30 angels rushed to take this dua to Allah. So this beautiful dua of one line, half a line, two lines, should not we remember? Should not we memorize? Should not we say every day, "May Allah give us tawfiq." Today we are praying seven people's janazah, seven people's. They can't say anymore, alhamdulillah, they have lost this chance. They'll be never complaining, "Oh, I didn't have enough big house to live. I couldn't buy a big car." They'll be not making all this problem now, all this complaint now. They'll be only saying, "With what I came to Allah to meet him. May Allah give us tawfiq before such a time come to us." أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولساء المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.